अच्छा जी, मैं डी राजा साहब से आग्रह करूं, पर राजा साहब हैं इसलिए मैं निवेदन पहले करना चाहूँगा, प्लीज वन मिनट। यह बहुत महत्वपूर्ण विषय है, हम सब जानते हैं, और शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन डिस्कशन के तहत इस पर हम लोग बातचीत कर रहे हैं, जो 2.5 घंटे की होती है, आधे घंटे मंत्री जी का जवाब, 3:15 बजे यह बहस शुरू हुई, 5:15 बजे तक हमें कॉन्क्लूड करना है। अभी बहुत सारे स्पीकर्स के नाम हैं, पर हर समूह से एक एक व्यक्ति बोल सके ये कोशिश है, अदरवाइज हम बहस कॉन्क्लूड नहीं कर पाएंगे, इसलिए हमारी व्यवस्था होगी समय के लिए, और जो स्पीकर सब छूट जाएंगे ये उन दलों के लिए भी, क्योंकि उन दलों के व्यू आ जाए ये कोशिश हुई है। इसलिए राजा साहब, रिक्वेस्ट फॉर 3 मिनट्स, एंड आई थिंक दिस रिक्वेस्ट यू विल
ओके। थैंक यू सर,
प्लीज।
थैंक यू सर। द प्राइम मिनिस्टर टुडे इन हिज स्पीच रेफर्ड टू वाटर क्राइसिस in 226 districts. It shows the dimension of the problem. There is a drought in many parts of the country. Sir, Tamil Nadu is one state which is passing through unprecedented water crisis. There is drinking water crisis in major cities like Chennai and several villages. People are agitating, taking pots in their hands, demanding water supply. So there is unrest in the state of Tamil Nadu. And in this regard, I would like to make a few observations. One, despite rainwater harvest, despite conversion of seawater into drinking water, Chennai is facing a severe water crisis, drinking water crisis. Sir, Tamil Nadu is one state which has river water problem, because except one river, all other rivers are interstate rivers. So there is interstate river water dispute, and center should see these disputes are settled in a fair manner. The riparian states should have equal rights. For instance, Tamil Nadu is a lower riparian state as far as Kaveri is concerned, Palar is concerned, and it should be ensured Tamil Nadu should have its equal right on these rivers, and it should get fair share, because there is crisis, no water for irrigation, no water for cultivation. What Tamil Nadu will do? And Delta districts have become drought-prone districts, famine conditions are emerging. This is a serious problem. So, center should address the interstate. That I explained, drinking water problem. Then, sir, the time has come, whether you will do it under Niti Aayog or under the ministry, the time has come, the interlinking of rivers must be discussed at national level, and there must be efforts to evolve a national consensus, because it is not a simple issue, but we should try to evolve a national consensus, and the linking of rivers must be given adequate attention, and there must be national level discussion. Then, sir, preservation, conservation of water bodies. Because we have the system of lakes, ponds, and everything, but we don't preserve them, we don't conserve them, and it is to be taken up on a priority basis, preservation and conservation of water bodies. And there are encroachments. There are several judicial verdicts. Encroachments should be removed. But whenever we talk of encroachments, always people think it is poor people who go and occupy lake sites or river sites. Target will become, becomes poor people. It should not be the approach. The corporate houses, land mafias, even government agencies, they encroach upon the water bodies and they construct buildings. And how to address this issue? And blame should not be on poor people. And poor people can go, because they live in huts. Anytime if you ask them, they will go.
Raja, but Raja sir,
I am finishing. Please, sir. Please. So this issue should be addressed. Moreover, we are living in a time where global warming is has become a global issue. Environmental changes have become global issues. In such a background, how to address the question of water? Water management must be a priority, primary priority of both central government and state governments, and preservation of forests must be another area of concern, and government
thank you,
will have
thank
to
you, Raja, sir.
Address.
Thank you.
With these suggestions, I conclude.
Thank you for good suggestions.